Midway between the Alberta border and the west coast of British Columbia, the blue waters of Lake Okanagan stretch 80 miles through one of the nation's most beautiful and bountiful valleys. Enjoying over 2,000 hours of sunshine annually, it's only natural that residents of and visitors to the Okanagan would enjoy a great variety of sports, including a 1968 version of Ben-Hur. Combining the desire to play hard with the ability to work hard, the residents of Kelowna, B.C. have built a prosperous and modern city on the eastern shore of Lake Okanagan. Careful planning, with an eye to the rapidly changing future, has resulted in a city of handsome streets and buildings, excellent public services, and an abundance of lovely parks. It took 7 years of tireless effort by dedicated Kelownians to bring the Brier to their city. Long noted for its summer sports activities, Kelowna plays host to the 1968 Canadian Curling Championships. Ogopogo, legendary longtime resident of the lake, will undoubtedly find the rumble of stones and the crack of brooms a bit different to the usual water sports. For more than 60 years, the second week of August has been set aside for the annual Kelowna Regatta, attracting the finest aquatic performers in America. While water skiing, swimming, and diving appeal to the younger set, the magnificent weather in the Okanagan has moved tourism into a major industry, with outdoor activities to suit all tastes and all ages, winter and summer. Kelowna's residents can be justly proud of their truly beautiful 18-hole golf course looking out over the lake. But behind all of this beauty and fun lies a hard-working community that has built its prosperity on the area's basic wealth, the apple orchards, which were founded over 100 years ago by an oblate priest, Father Pandozi. In addition, and looking for all the world like a scene from Germany's Rhine Valley, vast vineyards stretch in orderly rows along the edge of the lake. Two wineries are building a rapidly growing secondary industry in Kelowna. And here again, the California-like climate of the area plays a major role. And it was to this lovely and colorful valley and the hospitable city of Kelowna that Canada's provincial curling champions traveled early in March. They were to compete for the MacDonald Brier Tanker. On opening day, curling fans started forming at Memorial Arena, where a huge 10-foot curling stone set the proper mood. The combined pipe bands of the Kelowna branch of the Canadian Legion and the McIntosh Ladies Organization led the curlers down the ice. To veteran or first-time competitor, this is the most colorful moment in any Brier. Harold Long, committee chairman, officially welcomed the curlers and dignitaries to the playdowns. Then David Pugh, federal MP for the area, added his best wishes. Representing the British Columbia government, Dudley Little extended a king-sized welcome to all curling fans. His worship, Mayor Parkinson, complimented the hard-working local committee for bringing the Brier to Kelowna. DCA President Bill Lumsden said a few words of welcome to the rinks, and then it was time for Chief Justice Culleton, newly appointed Brier trustee, to hold the broom for fellow trustee member, the Honorable Colin Campbell. Coley delivers the opening stone.